In this video, we're going to talk about oil-water separators, what they are, how they work, and how you apply them with wastewater management. G'day, Josh. How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. Oil-water separators, I don't even really know what they are. Can you start with what they are and how they work?
So an oil-water separator is used within a wash bay, primarily, say, like a vehicle wash bay. So it does remove the oil from the water before it gets discharged into your trade waste network.
Okay.
So that is a requirement by the water authorities in your area.
Right, because I imagine if oil actually gets into the water supply, bad things can happen, to say nothing of, I guess, some kind of authority showing up at your door being angry.
That's exactly right. So the fines can be quite high if you don't have those systems in place.
Okay, so what does an oil water separator look like? Is it like a sieve? Is it chemical? What sort of are we talking about?
It's basically a big square or rectangle device with different types of media bags inside the machine itself.
Okay.
So the water flows through, filters the water, and basically discharges out the back end.
Okay, so do you need to, I want to say, maintain these or empty them? Or?
You do. So you do have to keep up to a regular servicing schedule, but that is dependent on your particular application on where the separator is being used.
Okay, so let's talk about some of those applications. You've said wash bays, so I'm thinking drive a car into a bay of some kind, wash it, and this collects up or processes all the waste that comes out, is that right?
Pretty much, yes. So any vehicle wash bay that you go to wash your family vehicle, they're used in that application, but also for mining companies, mechanical workshops, if they're doing gearbox changes, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
These are required because there can be oils introduced into that water when washing those particular items.
What are some of the most unusual uses you've seen of oil water separators?
Actually, one of them was to wash wheelchairs.
So really?
Even though there was no oil.
There's not a person on the wheelchair at the time.
No.
Yeah, okay.
So it was just wheelchairs by themselves, but they still did require the oil and water separator.
Mm.
And same with Tesla. Even though they're electric vehicles, they still required an oil and water separator.
Because there's got to be oil in there somewhere to sort of lubricate all
the gearboxes and stuff like that.
Cool. And we're talking about sort of the environmental wastewater treatment. In other words, making sure that the water, by the time it's done, is clean enough to go into the normal sewerage system.
Yeah.
Have I got that right?
Correct.
Okay, cool. Are there different kinds of oil water separators?
There are. There are two types of oil separators, which one is the coalescing plate separator and the other one is the hydrocyclone separator.
Okay, you just said a whole bunch of words there, but none of them meant anything. Can you describe a little better?
So the coalescing plate separators, they are a lot more simple to use. There is only one mechanical part, which is the pump itself.
Mm.
That's pushing the water through the device.
Okay.
Everything in the device is stationary, so the water just flows through. The hydrocyclone is a lot more complicated, which we will touch on a later video.
There are different kinds of oil water separators, different sizes, different applications. How do you figure out which one is right for your business?
The best approach is to speak to someone professional that understands the type of application that you're looking to use the oil and water separator in, and we can assist with sizing up and ascertaining what separator would suit your particular purpose.
All right, so talk to someone who knows and arguably give us a call.
That's exactly right.
Terrific. Thanks very much, Josh.
Thank
for those
you.
Of you who'd like to find out more or figure out which of these is right for your business, please get in touch with us online through bulbeckenviro.com.au or send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to help and answer all of your questions.